Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy, and today I'm talking about simplifying complex fractions or complex expressions. And that just means something like this, where we have fractions in the numerator or the denominator or both. And the idea is to take an expression with fractions in the numerator and denominator and simplify it so that there are no fractions in the numerator or denominator. That's what simplifying it means. I have two basic methods. In the first method, we combine the numerator, we combine the denominator, and then we divide and simplify if necessary. In the second method, we find the least common denominator, multiply every term by the least common denominator, and then simplify the result. So I'm going to do this problem in both ways, and then I'll do one using method one and another one using method two. So to combine the numerators, we need to subtract 1 minus 1 over x. The least common denominator for that is x. So I'm going to rewrite this problem. And instead of having two fractions, I'm going to have one. The least common denominator is x. The first one doesn't have an x, so we need to multiply the top and the bottom by x. That gives us x on the bottom, which I have, and then x on the top. And the second one already has the x, so we don't have to change that at all. We have the x on the bottom, so we have minus 1. So we just combine the numerator into one fraction. I'm going to do the same thing to the bottom. I can see that in the denominator, the LCD would be x squared. So I'm going to have x squared down here. The first one I've got to multiply by x squared on top and bottom. And down here, I don't have to multiply by anything because it already had the x squared, so I have minus 1. Now I've combined the numerators and I've combined the denominators. Now I'm going to divide because what this says is x minus 1 over x divided by x squared minus 1 over x squared. Right? So that's just a division. And now to finish dividing that, I flip, right? X minus 1 over x times the x squared goes to the top because I'm flipping that because I'm dividing. And the x squared minus 1, I'm going to go ahead and factor that. That's going to be x plus 1 and x minus 1. So now I want to simplify by striking out the like terms. I have x minus 1. I can take out there and there. And then x goes into itself once, but x up here would cancel one of those, leaving one behind. So what I have is x on the top and x plus 1 in the denominator. And now I don't have a complex fraction because I don't have any fractions in the numerator or the denominator. I just have a straightforward fraction. Let's look at the second method for that. The second method says find the LCD and multiply every term by it. This LCD is x to the second power. I have two x's here, so I need to multiply everything by x squared. And what's going to happen is, in the first case, I'm going to have x squared. In the second one, this x will cancel one of those, leaving x, so minus x. And then I have x squared, and these x squareds are going to cancel, minus 1. So now I need to factor. I have multiplied everything by the LCD, but the simplifying is the big part in this problem. And so I'm going to factor out a common factor of x at the top. I'm going to get x minus 1. And I'm going to factor the difference of squares down here like I did in the other one, x plus 1, x minus 1. And now I can see that the x minus 1's cancel, leaving the same answer that I got over here. Different method, completely different method, but it gives you the same answer. So it's kind of up to you. I typically like the second method better when things aren't too complicated like this one. We don't have too complicated denominators. But let's take a look at my second example I have for you. In this one, I'm going to use method number one. Method number two. I'm going to find the least common denominator, multiply everything by it, and then see what happens. Well, first, before I can find the LCD, I need to factor everything. So I'm going to rewrite this as 3 over 2 times x minus 1 and I'm going to factor x squared minus 1 as x plus 1 x minus 1. And now I'm going to find an LCD. And when I find an LCD, I'm going to multiply everything by it. So starting with this first one for my LCD, I need a 2 because I see a 2 there. I need an x minus 1 because I see an x minus 1 there. Coming over here, I see an x plus 1, so I need that. Coming down here, I need an x minus 1. I already have it. X plus 1, I already have it. Excuse me. X minus 1, I already have it. So there's my LCD right there, 2, x minus 1, x plus 1. Everything gets multiplied by that. It doesn't take that long to write this. You might want to try stopping the video and finishing this problem out and see if you can do it without my help, and then come back and check in and see how you did. Part of it is I wrote it out because it's easier to make mistakes when you skip those kind of steps. All right, I'm canceling the 2s. I'm canceling the x minus 1. And so what's left is 3 and x plus 1. Here, I'm canceling the x plus 1s. I have a negative, negative 2x minus 1. Then down below, my x minus 1s cancel. I have 2 and x plus 1. And over here, I have x minus 1. Sorry, x plus 1s and x minus 1s that cancel, and I have 2 times x. I can't cancel anything in this format. I can't say, oh, let's just cancel that, because it's part of a binomial. I can't do it. I have to simplify by multiplying everything out first. So if I multiply out the top, I get 3x plus 3 minus 2x plus 2. And on the bottom, 2x plus 1 plus 2x. And now I'm going to continue simplifying. 3x minus 2x is x. 3 plus 2 is 5. On the bottom, 2x plus 2x is 4x plus 1. So I have nothing to, I can't factor anymore. I can't cancel anything else. So that is my answer. My answer is simplified because there's no fractions in the numerator and there's no fractions in the denominator. And this one I used method 2, which was to find the least common denominator, multiply every term by it, and then simplify. And in this case, the simplify is the difficult part of that. Okay, one more example, and this one I'm going to use method 1. And that is to combine the numerators, combine the denominators, and then divide. You might want to just focus on one of these methods and only use one method. I just wanted to show you both. And for me, sometimes one method is easier than the other, so I like knowing both. But I would leave it up to you. Okay, so here's my new fraction bar. What's my LCD on the top? Well, I have a standalone Y and a Y plus 8. So my LCD is going to be Y and y plus 8. What is this one missing of the new thing? Well, it's missing the y plus 8. So I have to multiply the top and the bottom by y plus 8. This gives me this, which I already have. And 1 times y plus 8 gives me y plus 8. Now over here, what am I missing? Well, I'm missing the y. And so I have to multiply the top and the bottom by y, and I get plus y. Haven't done yet, but I'm going to go ahead and do the bottom, and then we'll clean up the top in a minute here. So down below, I have a y and a y minus 8, right? And so when I write that, I'm missing the y here. So I get 8y. And down here, I'm missing the y minus 8. So I get negative 9 times y minus 8. I want to be careful that I don't forget about that sign because it's going to change things. What do I have on the top now? Well, on the top I have y plus y, which is 2y plus 8. So I have 2y plus 8 over y times y plus 8. I don't want to factor, I don't want to multiply that stuff out on the bottom because I want to be able to factor it out if I can. I'm going to have to factor that top, it looks like, as well. What do I have in the denominator? Well, I have 8y, let me write it over here, 8y minus 9y plus 72. So 8y minus 9y is negative y and plus 72. And in the denominator, I have y and y minus 8. So now I've combined the numerators, I've combined the denominators, and I'm ready to divide. I'm going to take 2 out of up here. So 2y plus 8, I can take out that 2, right, and get 2y plus 4. So I have 2 and y plus 4 over y and y plus 8 divided by negative y plus 72 over y and y minus 8. So now I'm going to flip that. Hold on, that was negative 9y plus 72. Yeah, okay. And now I'm going to flip that. This goes on and on, right? 2y plus 4 over y plus 8 times y minus 8 over negative y plus 72. And I don't like that. I'm going to fix that up in a second. And I want you to remember that when you do the problem too. We don't like a lead term of negative. So anyway, what happens here? These y's cancel. And I get 2 and y plus 4 and y minus 8 on the top. And I get y plus 8, but I'm going to take out the negative here. Because it's bad form to have your lead term be negative. So I'm going to factor out the negative. I'm going to put that here. So I have negative y plus 8 and y minus 72. That is not an easy problem, and you have to think about that, go back through it. But what we did was combine the numerators, combine the denominators, and then divided the two, and there was simplifying all the way through. I've done this with both methods, and I think that this method is maybe a little easier than the other one, but you can try it with the other method, that is finding the LCD, and see if you can get down to the same answer. Remember, if you have a lead term that's negative, I'm going to want you to factor that negative out. So that would be negative y plus 72, right? I just took the negative out because that's a better way to write an answer. And then your final answer, that negative could be in the bottom or the top or the front. I would accept it either way. All right, have a fantastic day.